Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is so good to greet you and to welcome you to this, the year-end concert of the Crown of the Continent Choir and the Headwaters Ensemble. We've been working hard this year for many things, but one of our favorite things is this evening, and a time to share with our friends, family, loved ones. As I told the choir in the green room, you're singing for a crowd that already loves you, so you have no reason to be nervous, and just to have a good time tonight. We're delighted this year to be in collaboration with John Ashley, a marvelous photographer, and you've seen some of his work already out in the lobby tonight. And I've asked Amy Vanderbilt to introduce him, because she knows him, has known him for a good long time, and then we will be off to the races.
The stories we could tell, right, John? We won't hear. I've had the pleasure of knowing John Ashley and his wife, Tracy Sheets, for 20 plus years. We met while working for the National Park Service up at Glacier. John has always stood out from the crowd as a wildlife biologist and more recently as an artist. While working for the National Park Service, John's work focused on the conservation of California condors, bald eagles, and his favorite, harlequin ducks. After graduating from the University of Montana with a degree in wildlife biology, John's images transitioned from sports, campus, and other urban settings and subjects to the natural world. His long-standing concern about the effects of nighttime lighting on both humans and wildlife and animals alike has helped with the decade-long effort and nomination to establish Waterton Glacier International Peace Park as the world's first international dark sky park. Thank you. Hopefully most of you are familiar with John's dark sky imagery. If not, you're in for a wonderful treat this evening. Please join me in welcoming my dear friend, the incomparable and multi-talented John Ashley.
Thank you, Amy. Thank you, Greg. I'm not sure who she was talking about, but my name also happens to be John Ashley. Now, except for you and me, does it sometimes seem like the rest of the world has gone nuts, especially lately? So when the world gets crazy and I'm stressed out, even though I'm a photographer, I turn to music. When I'm feeling anxiety, I need my music. When I feel like I need a hug, that's when I have to sneak up on my wife, but that's a different story. Anyway. Art has a purpose, and that purpose is to try to reach into our souls and touch something that's deep down inside of us. And so what we're going to do tonight is have these voice artists behind me. They're going to massage your souls with song while I pluck at your heartstrings with photographs. And hopefully the synergy will move you to some degree. So our goal, our goal, is to have you feel better about the world when you wake up tomorrow than how you felt about it when you woke up this morning. Because that's what community is for, and because love really does live here in Whitefish, Montana. So, yes. So sit back and relax and let us take some of that stress away. Enjoy.
Composer, song leader, conductor, and author Nick Page has focused his writing for children and adults on building of humanitarian bridges. In tonight's opening piece, written in an early American shaped note style, Mr. Page encourages us to discover the light we possess within and to share that light through acts of compassion.
next two pieces were written by Seth Houston. He's the director of choral activities at the University of California, Irvine, who, when a college student, worked for a summer on a guest ranch near Big Sky, Montana. That summer was exceptionally cold and wet, which gave Houston time in his cabin to reflect on his surroundings and to compose. He also borrowed from the American shaped note style of writing for these two compositions, conveying through his music and texts a deep love and concern for the earth in which we live.
When the way is clear and sunlight shines, we pursue our way. With nary a fear, we follow straight lines, day after blinding day.
But the path gets blocked.
But the path gets blocked.
The path gets blocked.
The sky gets blocked. And the sky turns
passing us through.
Come down,
hear the whistle 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 down,
hear the
blessing from above.
And the
Lullaby, by young American composer Daniel Elder, serves as a simple and beautiful song of reassurance, as a mother may sing to her child to stave off a fear of the darkness and solitude of night. The beauty of this original text lies in its dual nature, as it also serves to comfort those who grieve over loss. The line, "The day is done and gone the sun," borrows from the first line of text accompanying the traditional taps tune observed at some memorial services.
Thank you. Eriks Esenvalds, born in 1977 in Latvia, is one of the most sought-after choral composers working today. With a busy commission schedule and performances of his music heard on every continent, he recently completed 2 years as guest lecturer in music at Trinity College, Cambridge. His piece, Stars, commissioned by the Salt Lake Choral Artists with a text by poet Sarah Teasdale, is evocative of the vast expanse of the heavens as witnessed from a place not unlike the dark reaches of night we find here in Montana. It expresses a deep sense of awe, reverence, and gratitude common to those who have shared this experience.
Oh,
Abendlied, which means evening song in German, is a sacred motet by Josef Rheinberger for a six-part mixed choir. It has been regarded as his best-known sacred composition. He wrote the first version in 1855 at the age of 15. The text is a verse from the biblical narration of Jesus' appearance on the road to Emmaus, according to Luke 24:29, in Martin Luther's German version of the Bible.
Ohtul, dusk, an incredibly beautiful work by well-loved Estonian composer Eriks Uusberg. The poem speaks of evening and of images we associate with dusk.
Thank you.
improvisation, Ola Diego or Diego writes, improvising on the piano over my own a cappella works is something I've been doing for many years. Each time the improvisations are different and completely unprepared. I never planned on notating any of them, but as this particular improvisation garnered a lot of YouTube views and people started asking for the transcription, I figured it made sense to create a score as close to the original performance as I could notate. Improvisation is one of my greatest passions, and so I'm happy to finally be able to share this one, which especially is especially close to my heart, with other performers and choirs. This evening, we're honored to have our very own Dan Kohnstamm, one of our own and this group's former accompanist, as the featured pianist on this piece.
Thank you. Daddy Elder's inspiration to set this simple but profound text came from its relationship to the taps bugle call, played traditionally in the military to signal lights out at the end of the day. This call is now played often at military memorials, symbolizing poignantly the closing of the last of days.
Canadian citizen, Stephen Chatman is a revered composer of many genres of music.
His works range from simple and immediately accessible to virtuosic. He has written much choral music descriptive of the Northwest Canadian region where he now lives and works. While text is the sculpting tool for many choral composers, often serving as the starting point and even structural basis for their work, Chatman flummoxes us by using imitative sounds to describe, for instance, the frustratingly tenacious woodpecker, or the dreaded buzzing that leads to the grunting of darn mosquito. Mosquitoes and woodpeckers, this too is our home.
Yeah.
Can You Feel the Love Tonight is a song from Disney's 1994 animated film, The Lion King, composed by Elton John with lyrics by Tim Rice. The song won both the Academy Award and Golden Globe Award that year for Best Original Song, as well as a Grammy for Best Pop Song, and was performed in the movie by Sir Elton John. The song speaks of the power of love to bring all aspects of life into proper focus and perspective.
With the human voice.
The composer created original words to achieve a variety of colors and mixed and matched them with the ensemble to produce a diverse sonic landscape.
Yum, 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 yum.
Her love of music, a passion reflected in her over 100 choral works, which have received thousands of performances worldwide. This piece, Song of Kabir, is the setting of the 15th century Indian mystic Kabir's devotional poem, as translated in 1915 by Rabindranath Tagore, and adapted by Alexander to reflect the universality of Kabir's deity.
You are the flower, the fruit.
manager?
I have to say something. I love that song, so you have to pardon me. Again, thank you all for coming. I'm Susan Cahill. I'm the president of the Crown of the Continent Choir. And for those of you who don't know about how we started, Kevin Allen Schmidt, who was the choir director of Flathead High School, had an idea of a community choir that sang for fun, but also to support environmental stewardship, social justice, and religious diversity. He did that for 4 years and then left the Valley, and the choir at the time wasn't sure that we were going to be able to continue to sing. And then, as I think I said 3 years ago, Craig Hodges sort of fell out of the sky and landed in Savannah High School choir room, and he's been there ever since. And he has helped us come together, I think, more as a choir, a little bit more seriously. He has worked diligently to find music that supports our mission. And we are very grateful for him for that. This is his last concert. He's leaving us to pursue other things and ideas and dreams in his life. And we have again been very lucky because we're going to have another very talented and experienced choir director, Morvilla Davis, who will start with us in the fall. But we, as a choir, want to let Craig know how much we have appreciated him and love him and will miss him. And I guess we didn't know what to do, and then Amy Vanderbilt said, well, maybe John Ashley can help us out. So he has. So this is for you, Craig. And I have to say one more thing. What I would love to see you do is hang it in a very special place so that you can see it a lot. And every time you look at it, you can remember us standing there, looking down at our music. And that you say tirelessly, maybe once in a while it'd be a good idea to get up, look at me. But so.
A few years ago, we did this with a number of photographers, and there was one image that I just, I was awestruck by. This is John's image, and it's called Heaven on Earth, and I believe I live there, right here in Montana. And he, I don't know if he had something in mind, but he asked me what my favorite of his images was. And here it is. So thank you, John, and thank you, choir. You have made my life a joy in so many ways, and I plan on writing some music that you can sing and I can listen to.
When Harry Belafonte was the guest star on an episode of The Muppet Show in 1979, he explained the inspiration for this song before he performed it with various Muppets in African garb. When Fozzie Bear asked him about the piece, Belafonte said, "I discovered that song in Africa. I was in a country called Guinea. I went deep into the interior of the country, and in a little village, I met with a storyteller. The storyteller went way back in African tradition and African mythology and began to tell this story about the fire, the sun, the water, the earth. He pointed out that the whole of these together turns the world around, and that all of us are here for a very, very short time. In that time that we're here, there really isn't any difference in any of us if we take the time out to understand each other. The question is, do I know who you are or who I am? And do we care about each other? Because if we do, together, we can turn the world around.